Kopbal van Hul Eco Tango Echo voor de Daily Minutes met een nieuwsupdate voor vandaag, 31 oktober 2015. Dit is het bulletin van zaterdag. Voor degenen die het nog niet gehoord hadden, met Poes is het goed afgelopen gisteren. Ze moet wel op een dieet voor haar nieren, maar dat is vooral ook omdat haar volle zus een paar jaar geleden is overleden aan een nierkwaal. Iedereen overigens bedankt voor de goede wensen gisteren en vandaag hierover. De uitzending vandaag is in het Engels en anders dan aangekondigd gaan we vandaag iets doen met Contestia. De digitale mode Contestia en dan wel op een aangepaste manier. Het aanpassen kun je doen door het pull-down menu. Helemaal onderaan is aangepast. En dan krijg je een schermpje en dan moet je invullen 125 bandbreedte, 2 tonen. Synchronisatie marge is 8. Integratie FEC blokken is 4. En de XMT start-stoptonen moeten aanstaan. Dus Contestia aangepast, 125 bandbreedte, 2 tonen. Synchronisatie 8, FEC 4, inclusief start-stop tonen. De data begint ergens tijdens de uitzending gewoon onder de spraak door. Oh ja, dat vergat ik. Frequentie is 350 hertz, 350 hertz. Just as every weekend, our show today is in English. We do have the propagation bulletin of the RSTB and some other news items. In this show we will experiment with data and speech simultaneously. Mode we use is Contestia. You will have to make some extra adjustments to FLDigi. The exact settings for today are Contestia, as I said, and then Customized, which is the lowest option in the pull-down menu. Bandwidth is 125, 2 tones, margin 8, integration of FEC is 4, and it is including start-stop tones. 125 bandwidth, 2 tones, Contestia, margin 8, integration of FEC 4, including start-stop tones. The data will start just somewhere during the bulletin. Frequency of the data will be 350, 350 Hz.
CQ, 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 calling all radio amateurs and shortwave listeners. This is GB2RS. The News Broadcasting Service of the Radio Society of Great Britain comes to you from G4NJH as usual, and you can find the script on the RSGB's own web pages. Good morning, it's Sunday the 1st of November 2015. This is GB2RS News. Now, radio propagation reports compiled from G0KYE and G3YLA. It's been another week with great HF conditions. Last weekend gave many people the chance to work DX up 10 metres in the CQ Worldwide Contest. The solar flux index stayed above 110 and geomagnetic conditions were generally quiet, especially compared with the problem we had with high-speed solar wind streams last month. This, coupled with better general or terminal propagation, meant the maximum usable frequency headed past 29 megs. Many low-powered 10-metre beacons in the US could be heard in the UK, which is always a good sign. However, there was also a proton event on Thursday that may have affected polar paths. Propagation on 10 metres to the USA, Caribbean and South America has improved dramatically, so make the most of it whilst it lasts. Next week, NOAA predicts the solar flux index will decline, possibly into the mid-80s. The K-index is predicted to rise to 5 or 6 on Tuesday or Wednesday due to incoming plasma from the sun. If the prediction is correct, expect MUFs to drop and HF conditions to be poorer midweek. As we know, in November, according to voacap.com, you should be using a smooth sunspot number 46.4 for your propagation prediction programs. Now for VHF and up propagation, the first week of November looks like getting off to an unsettled start on Sunday in the far north and west, but with some promising lift conditions in the southeast of the country. This could be the start of a good week for VHF-UHF microwave ducting, with high pressure residing over the continent for much of the time, and allowing substantial parts of the UK to couple into the action. Even the north should benefit from these quieter weather conditions later. The most likely extended paths will be towards the south of France, as far as the Alps and Pyrenees, and eastward towards the North Sea to the Baltic, so it's a good week for checking the multimode sections of the band. SSB and CW should prove especially rewarding, and it's worth spending a few minutes getting a beacon list printed off. If you're new to these higher frequencies, remember that cross-polarisation is not a good philosophy for VHF DXing. It may be time to experiment with a simple horizontal wire dipole rather than struggle with a collinear. There are no major meteor showers this week, but we have the Leonids on the 17th and 18th of November to look forward to. for EME operators next week shows falling declination and the moon window length with increasing losses. There's still plenty of moon time with up to 15 hours of moon visibility on Monday, falling to 12 hours next Sunday when losses will be close to maximum. And that's it from the propagation team for this week. The Amateur Radio on the International Space Station, or ARIS, programme has marked its 1,000th Space Station Amateur Radio event. It started 15 years ago when the programme established the first permanent amateur radio presence in space. The inaugural ARIS contact took place on the 21st of December 2000 between a school near Chicago and Commander William Shep Shepherd, KD5GSL. Several UK schools will have the opportunity to speak to UK astronaut Tim Peake in 2016. You can read more about his mission and his involvement with amateur radio on the RSGB website. Spectrum at 2.3 and 3.4 gigs that once was allocated to amateur radio is going on the auction block. Ofcom announced that this week. In April 2014, Ofcom announced that it was ending amateur radio access to significant portions of the 2.3 and 3.4 gigs bands following a year-long consultation. Amateur radio was secondary on both bands. Ofcom expect the frequencies to be of interest to mobile network operators and others involved with mobile broadband. The 5 MHz beacon GB3RSL, which is part of the 5 MHz beacon train, is currently off the air due to local difficulties. A decision about possible relocation of the beacon will be taken later in the year. UCube 1 has now completed its nominal mission following over 14 months of operations. Launched in July 2014, UCube 1 is a technology demonstration mission aimed at attracting and training future generations of engineers and engaging with students. Although the UK Space Agency supported mission phase has ended, discussion is underway with AMSAT UK about the possibility of taking over UCube 1 operations to continue its educational and outreach activities until the satellite orbit naturally degrades. Amateur radio's interests will be well represented when the 2015 ITU World Radio Communication Conference convenes on the 2nd of November in Geneva. Held every 3 or 4 years, the conferences review and, if necessary, revise the radio regulations, the international treaty governing the use of radio frequency spectrum. Delegates will consider several items of interest to the amateur radio community during the nearly month-long international gathering. Whilst most attention by amateurs is likely to be focused on the prospect of a 5 MHz allocation, several other topics are included that represent either threats or opportunities. The RSGB's detailed responses can be found on the website.
Welcome to the world of amateur radio.
From Golf Bravo 90, I can talk to people all over the world.
CQ, CQ, CQ. This is M.
As a radio amateur, I'm legally entitled to transmit to 400 watts.
Think for any other stations on the Monday Night Net here on GB3DA.
Amateur radio is a hobby with a difference. It's a technical hobby that lets you exchange messages with millions of amateur radio operators all around the world.
Zijn dagelijks om 1900 uur te beluisteren op PI2 NOS en 's ochtends om 10:30. Verder zijn de uitzendingen onder andere te beluisteren op youtube.com/PA0ETE.